Hello everyone, I am Dr. Raina Tembe and today we shall be discussing about the normal anatomy of the tracheobronchial tree and how to identify the various lobar and segmental bronchi. We have here a CT chest with a lung window setting in an axial and coronal plane. Let us start by having a look at the trachea. The trachea is a midline structure that divides at the level of carina into the right and the left mainstem bronchus. These mainstem bronchi then further divide into the various lobar and segmental bronchi. We shall first have a look at the right main bronchus followed by the left main bronchus. As we can see in this coronal plane, the right main bronchus is dividing into the right upper lobar bronchus and bronchus intermedius. We shall go to the axial plane now and identify the various lobar and segmental bronchi. This is the axial plane at the level of carina. We see the right main bronchus and the left main bronchus. This is the upper lobar bronchus arising from the right main bronchus. We shall be following this upper lobar bronchus now. So let us scroll through these images. As we scroll superiorly, we see that a segmental branch is arising from the upper lobar bronchus. This is going superiorly towards the apex of the right upper lobe. This will be the apical segment of the right upper lobe. As we go down inferiorly, we see that the upper lobar bronchus is dividing into two segments. The one which is going anteriorly is the anterior segmental bronchus. So this here is the anterior segmental bronchus, and the one which is going posteriorly is the posterior segmental bronchus. Now, as we go inferiorly, we see the bronchus intermedius. This bronchus intermedius divides into the middle lobar bronchus and the lower lobar bronchus. The middle lobar bronchus has two segments. The one segment which goes medially, we can see that this segment which is arising from the right middle lobe bronchus is going medially, will be the medial segmental bronchus, and the one which is going laterally will be the lateral segmental bronchus. We go back up again at the level of bronchus intermedius and identify its division and then identify the lower lobar bronchus. The first division that is coming is the superior segmental bronchus. We go inferiorly and identify one more segment which is arising from the medial aspect. This segment is the medial segmental bronchus as it is going towards the medial basal segment of the right lower lobe. The lower lobar bronchus then divides into three segments. We can see that this bronchus is dividing into three segments. This segment which is going anteriorly will be the anterior segmental bronchus. This segment, we trace it and we see that it is going laterally. This will be the lateral segmental bronchus, and this segment which is going posteriorly is the posterior segmental bronchus. Let us now have a look at the anatomy of the left bronchial tree. We go back to our coronal plane, see the trachea, right and the left main bronchus. Let us scroll through these images now. We can see that the left main bronchus is dividing into the upper lobar bronchus and the lower lobar bronchus. So we go back to our axial plane at the level of carina, identify the left main bronchus and follow this left main bronchus now. As we follow this left main bronchus and scroll through the images, we can see that it is dividing into the upper lobar bronchus and the lower lobar bronchus. Now let us first have a look at the anatomy of the upper lobar bronchus. The upper lobe of the left lung has four segments: apico-posterior segment, anterior segment, superior and inferior lingular segment. We shall be identifying the various segmental bronchi now. We go back to the level of the left main bronchus and we now identify the left upper lobar bronchus. So this is the upper lobar bronchus. Now we are going to go superiorly again. So when we scroll upwards, we see that there is a segmental branch which is going towards the apical and posterior aspects of the left upper lobe. This branch will be the apico-posterior segmental branch of the left upper lobe. As we go inferiorly, we see another branch which is arising and going anteriorly. So we trace this branch and we see that it is going anteriorly. This is the anterior segmental bronchus. When we go further inferiorly, we see another bronchus. This is the lingular bronchus. This lingular bronchus will be dividing into superior and inferior lingular segments. It shall be easier for us to identify these segments on the coronal plane. So we are going to switch back to the coronal image. We can see the left main bronchus here. We can see the upper lobar bronchus. Now follow this upper lobar bronchus. As we follow this upper lobar bronchus, we see the first division, which is the apico-posterior segmental bronchus. Now we follow this segment, which is going anteriorly. We see that there are two segments arising anteriorly. The one which is superior is the anterior segmental bronchus, and the one which is inferiorly is the lingular segmental bronchus. Now we follow this lingular bronchus and we see that it is dividing into two segments, the superior and inferior lingular segments. Now we shall have a look at the left lower lobe bronchus. So let us go back to our axial plane and we identify the left main bronchus. As we scroll inferiorly, we identify the upper lobar bronchus and the lower lobar bronchus. The first division arising will be the superior segmental bronchus. As we go inferiorly, we see that the left lower lobar bronchus is dividing into three segments. The one which is going towards the anterior and medial aspect of the left lower lobe will be the anteromedial segment. Let us trace this back again here. We can see that this segment is the anteromedial segment. Now we go back at the division of the left lower lobar bronchus and identify this segment. Now this segment is going laterally and will be the lateral segmental bronchus. This another segment which is going posteriorly will be the posterior segmental bronchus.